I'm an IT guy for many, many years. Like to hunt and fish and camp and ATV and basically love the outdoors, have fun doing that. One morning, one Sunday morning, I was shaving and I felt a lump on my neck. And it wasn't very big, it was probably the size of a marble. And so on Monday I called the doc and said, I got a lump, need to see you. And that's when they figured out it was lymphoma, large B-cell lymphoma.
You hear stage four and that's pretty final, so to speak.
That marble went from size of a marble to about the size of two baseballs. They started me on chemo and that seemed to start shrinking it. That worked for the first 5 months and then it quit working.
Dan had diffuse large B-cell lymphoma and he was not responsive to initial therapy. And what that means is we call that primary refractory disease. So in his case, he had the indication for proceeding on to CAR T-cell therapy after he was defined to be chemo refractory.
To me, it was a relief to know that there was yet another option.
CAR T-cell therapy has allowed us to treat patients who have no other options, and the response rates are phenomenal.
I was really glad that all that was available, where, you know, 10 years ago, they'd have just sent you home.
CAR T-cell therapy stands for chimeric antigen receptor T-cell therapy. T-cells are an important part of your immune system. Essentially, what I explain to patients is that they recognize what looks like you and doesn't look like you. But it's way more complicated than that. We take out patients' own T-cells and re-engineer them to recognize the cancer as bad. That is something that the patient's immune system isn't able to do because the cancer comes from them. Therefore, their immune system can't recognize the cancer as bad. We need to get those cells out somewhere. So we need to place a line that will allow the machine to do its job, which is to take out those cells very quickly and put everything back inside it. And that often takes about 3 weeks for that whole process to occur. So then the patient comes back to us as well as those cells, and then we do the treatment. We call that day zero, the day of the infusion of the CAR Ts.
I felt like it was sort of a scene out of like a Hollywood movie, because they roll in this cryogenic barrel and open the top and fog rolls out like a like it's truly a movie, and they pull out this little bag with a white, you know, small thing, and they're like, this is it.
It's a fairly simple procedure, but you end up being in the hospital for a while because your immune system does bottom out. And you have to build that back up before they'll let you out. And that takes a couple of weeks.
I felt very prepared ahead of time because they had told us the entire plan all the way through, you know, all the different possible things that could go wrong and what they were already in place and ready to do in case those things happen.
And then roughly at day 30 is when we're gonna look to see how the response was.
He started to be a little antsy. They wanted him to stay inside. And after like a month, he was, you could tell he was feeling back to normal and he wanted to get out and do more stuff.
Dan is now in a long-term follow-up plan. Right now we see him every 6 months. He's doing quite well.
The chemo hit me harder than the CAR T did. I have neuropathy in my feet from the chemo, but as far as side effects from the CAR T, I don't seem to have any. I'm as close to normal as you can get.
The CBCI team was amazing. I would kiss their feet, I would hug them, I would thank them, and I do thank them all the time.
I don't think there's words. The profession that they have chosen is a tough profession. How they can show up every day with a smile on their face and make everybody else feel good because they are upbeat and everything, I don't know how you do that. And that's extremely important.